Have you ever logged into your Google Tag Manager account and saw a bunch of new tags created, changed, or deleted? Who did this? Chances are you are not the only one working on your tag deployments. GTM can be great for collaboration, bigger tagging projects together with others, but sometimes it might be hard to keep it all straight so you don't overwrite other people's changes. In this video, we're gonna take a look at some tips and tricks how you can work effectively with others inside of Google Tag Manager. All or more, coming up. Hey there, Magic Geeks, Julian here, back with another video. Today I thought I'd give you a few tips on collaborating with others inside of a GTM account. To get started, it's always useful to audit a few things up front. Go into your admin section and actually look into who has access to your account. Then you might want to take a look at the version log to see who normally publishes changes in your tracking. And lastly, click into the container versions and see who is usually doing most of the changes around these containers. Once that is done, let's get on to tip number one, which is communication. Yes, before we get into all the tech features of GTM, we need to establish one thing, and it's communication. So if you haven't yet, get in contact with all those who collaborate with you in this account, set up a meeting and discuss how you want to be handling changes going forward. Who is working on what? How is testing be handled? Who is responsible for publishing? This can be vital information to get clear on right from the start. Tip number two, establishing documentation. To stay organized, you hopefully already have a strong naming convention for your tags, triggers, and variables set up. Agreeing with other collaborators on just one is vital to keep your container clean and usable, also to avoid duplications of any assets or unnecessary bloat of your container. Which brings us to tip number three, use workspaces. To avoid overwriting other people's changes, GTM has this nifty feature called workspaces. In the free version, you can create three of those and they help you make changes separately from others. The way they work is that when you create a new workspace, it actually makes a copy of the current version of your container and you can work on that workspace independently from others and do your changes. Once you are done with all your implementations, you can create a version of your workspace and other people will get a notification, other workspaces will get a notification to update their workspace with the newest changes. If you're familiar with version control systems just like Git, it's kind of similar, just that it has only one branch that you can merge into. And I'll have a post down below which explains this a little bit more in depth. But my recommendation would be that every collaborator simply opens up their own workspace once they start working on a new implementation project, like enhanced e-commerce tracking, for example. This avoids conflicts and keeps changes separately from others. Tip number four, approval queue. Now, approval queue is a feature of GTM 360 that might not be available to everyone, but the idea behind it is that there's a separation between who is creating versions of a container and who is then publishing them. So there would be implementers with a permission to create a container and only one or a group of people who can actually publish them to the live website. In the free version, we can kind of model this by giving certain permissions to certain people. So there's a permission that you can publish a version to the live website, but there's also the approve permission that only gives you the permission to create a version. So you would give collaborators that approve permission so they can go in and actually make their changes, create their tag deployment, test it, but then also create a version. And that is then kind of submitted to those who have the ability to publish that version. They can go in, QA that version again, and then ultimately push it live. And they are then responsible for these changes. This establishes a clear chain of command and creates a way to publish tags in a two-step process rather than just going in and changing stuff around and then publishing it live right away. Tip number five is to publish often. For those of you who have gone on the scavenger hunt of finding a bug in a tracking deployment, you know what I'm talking about. Oftentimes there are so many little different pieces that go into a tracking deployment that it's sometimes hard to find which pieces actually are intertwined and finding the error from them. That's where every simplification really helps inside of a bigger tracking deployment. And we can avoid too big of problems by publishing our containers more often rather than waiting until many changes have accumulated and then push them out in one place. Through smaller releases, we can also give us a little bit of time in between releases because we can go into our data set and see if we spot any kind of mistakes and then adjust accordingly. All right, these were really the big five things I could come up with and I think are important, but there are many smaller features that can be quite helpful if it applies to your case. So here are some bonuses. First of all, environments. These are essentially different GTM snippets that you can install on your staging and your live website to test your tracking separately from different platforms. This might be useful when you want to stage your changes first before then deploying them to the live environment. Then we have folders. These are another case for documentation. You could use them to indicate responsibilities, like all the Facebook tags are in the responsibility of the Facebook agencies and everything that is in that folder can't be touched by somebody else. Then we have the approval queue. As mentioned, this is a GA360 feature that lets you create a more rigid approval process. I have a link to a post down below that explains this in a little bit more detail. Lastly, notifications. This is a must-have feature for every account owner, and it's really a new feature that you can now configure to get an email every time there is a new version created or a new version published in your container. Great for being aware of changes, especially if you're not the only one making them. Now, obviously, all of this depends on the business you're working on, your collaborators, and the inner workings of your organization, but I hope this gives you some good ideas on how you can start using GTM effectively together with others. But I'd love to hear from you as well. What are your rules or processes around collaborating in GTM? Leave us a comment down below, and we can learn from each other. And if you want to have more tips and tricks on how you can keep your GTM account clean, check out this video right over there. I think you'll find some really cool tips. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.